Hi, I'm Stucky from Elgato, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to get the best camera quality for Zoom, Slack, or Microsoft Teams video conferencing calls. Now, if you find yourself in a lot of video conference calls, and let's face it, you probably are if you're watching this video, you're probably wondering how you can get your webcam to look better. Whether it's your laptop's built-in webcam, a standalone webcam, or maybe you have a full camera connected to your computer. But hopefully, these tips will help you get that extra bump in quality. Now, there are three parts to getting a good image for your video calls, and that's your lighting, your camera, and your lens. Now, before I go into those three parts, I think it's important to briefly go over camera exposure as a whole. Now, in order to get an image on your camera, you need to have your exposure captured. And there are three working components in a camera or webcam that comprise your exposure so you're properly lit. Those three components are your aperture, your shutter speed, and your ISO. Now, aperture refers to the opening of the lens that feeds your image to the sensor. Now, the wider the aperture is, the more light it lets in so you can be properly exposed. Next is your shutter speed, which is basically how much time your sensor is exposed to the image before it turns off again. So in a photo sense, you have an actual shutter covering your sensor and you tell it how long to be open. So if your shutter is open for 1 whole second, it'll be like this, which lets in a whole lot of light, versus something like 1/100th of a second, which is more like this, which isn't gonna let in as much light. This also comprises your frames per second. So if you want 60 FPS video, you need your shutter speed to be at least 1/60th of a second, so you get all 60 images per second for your video. Now lastly is your ISO, which refers to the sensitivity of your sensor, which is almost like your starting point for what the first two components affect your image exposure overall. So let's take a quick look at this webcam image with no lights. Right now, the image is really dark, and we want to bring it up to proper exposure. Now, let's start with aperture. Now, the wider the aperture you have, the more light it'll let in. However, the wider the aperture, the more shallow the depth of field is. However, this is actually seen as a benefit to a lot of people, since if you're working with a mirrorless camera or a DSLR, lenses with really wide open apertures is what causes those really nice blurry backgrounds. So as a general rule of thumb, you want your aperture to be as open as possible, which on a standard webcam is a fixed aperture anyway, so it's sort of a non-issue either way. So now that that's out of the way, we have two ways to bring our image back up to exposure. We can either raise the gain slider, which will increase the ISO. However, the higher the ISO, the grainier the image gets, or we can slow down the shutter speed. However, the slower the shutter speed is, it can get so low that your video will end up looking choppy, because remember, the shutter speed is equal to the frames per second, so if you're shooting at less than 1/60th of a second, you're not getting 60 FPS video, and if you're shooting at slower than 1/30th of a second, you're not even getting 30 frames per second. So you really want to avoid having your camera signal being something like 10 FPS because it's gonna look really choppy. So as it stands, neither of these options are really ideal. However, there is one more thing we can do to brighten up this image, and that's using lighting. So when you end up using lighting on your picture, this is gonna shift all the effects of the different settings in your exposure as compared to when no lights were on. So back when I had no lights on, if I had the gain slider up all the way, the image might be properly exposed even if it's really grainy. But when you have the lights on, if you have the gain on max, your image is gonna be completely blown out. So now we get to lower it. And we also get to increase our shutter speed, so the video is gonna be smoother now. So lighting is super huge for video quality, but also the quality of that lighting matters, because you don't want a super harsh non-diffuse light source, because it'll create harsh shadows and harsh hotspots. Now in this scene, I'm using an Elgato key light because it's very easy to configure, it's easy to mount on my desk, and it doesn't take up a lot of space, and most of all, it produces a nice soft light. Another thing you want to keep in mind is you want to try to keep the brightness of your background fairly level with the brightness of your foreground. So in my home office setup, I have a really large window. So during the daytime, a lot of sunlight comes in even through my blinds. So if I were to only use a floor lamp for my lighting for my video calls, either the background would be super blown out or I would basically be a silhouette. However, when I use Elgato key lights, I'm able to crank the brightness up on that to even the foreground and the background lighting, so then everything looks better. So next up, we have the camera. So instead of using a webcam, you can use Elgato Cam Link to connect a real camera to your computer to act as your webcam. When you use a camera like a camcorder, a mirrorless camera, or a DSLR, you have a much larger image sensor, which has less noise and grain in the picture for the same ISO levels, and also captures more detail and richer colors. It's one of those things that scales though. To get better quality, you spend more money. So the key is to come up with your budget and then choose accordingly. In this clip, I'm using a Sony A5100 because it offers amazing quality and can be purchased for about $300 used on eBay or $450 new on Amazon. Also in this clip, I'm just using the kit lens, which Aperture doesn't result in the blurry background image that we were discussing earlier. So to get that, you would want a lens with a wider aperture. So instead of the kit lens that has a f3.5 max aperture, here's a clip of the Sigma 16mm f1.4 lens, which has a maximum aperture of f1.4, which, if you didn't know, the smaller the number is for aperture, the wider it actually is. So it's sort of like golf, the lower number is better. And so if I use this lens, the background is super blurry and very pleasing. However, getting lenses that result in that kind of quality can get a little expensive. Another option you could go with is using a green screen to replace your background so you don't have to worry about those kinds of lenses. You could either add a custom image background, or there's even a tutorial you can follow by a YouTube channel called Alpha Gaming, where they show how you can use a green screen to get a blurry background, even with a webcam. We're going to link that in the description panel down below. And if you want to use your green screen for conference calls, be sure to check out a tutorial on how to do that, which is also linked in the description panel. But that's basically it. Essentially, the most important aspect of having a good image is lighting, but after that, it's what camera and lens you decide to go with, whether it's the budget webcam option, an inexpensive camcorder with CamLink, or a fancy mirrorless camera with interchangeable lenses. It's really up to you and what your budget allows. Anyway, once again, I'm Steggy from Elgato, and until our next video, good luck and have fun.